Good morning and welcome to Prayer and Devotion on this Friday. Today is Friday. It is September the 8th. Starting off this morning with Michael Jonkus, his I Have Loved You, and that was Chris Brunell singing it. It's actually on YouTube, not on an album, but I hope you enjoyed that. It's one of my favorite beloved. I always think of that as a Catholic song. I don't think it's in the United Methodist hymnal, but I love it, and I know it's in the when I've worshipped with some of my Catholic brothers and sisters. I've enjoyed that song, so I hope you liked it. As we start today, I want to welcome you warmly. We're going to be talking about loving one another. That's our devotion today, and we're looking at John chapter 15, verses 13 through 17. But I want to welcome you. I'm glad you're with us today. I'm praying for each one of you, no matter what you are walking through today. I pray that you come knowing that you are loved and prayed for, and so welcome. It's good to have you here today. So I invite you to open up your Bibles to John chapter 15, beginning in verse 13. And as you're doing that, my name is Cindy Stauffer. I am blessed to serve as the pastor at the United Methodist Church at New Brunswick. If you're ever looking for where we gather to worship on Sunday, we are right in the heart of the city, the church with the big red doors, the church that has a big heart for our city, right across from the State Theater. So I would love to have you join us, maybe even this Sunday, as we welcome 9 new members and have a baptism. So it'll be a blessed Sunday. But I'm glad you're with us now. Let's jump into John 15, beginning in verse 13. Jesus, in speaking to his disciples, "No one has greater love than this, to lay down one's life for one's friends. You are my friends if you do what I command you. I do not call you servants any longer, because the servant does not know what the master is doing. But I have called you friends, because I have made known to you everything that I have heard from my Father. You did not choose me, but I chose you, and I appointed you to go and bear fruit, fruit that will last, so that the Father will give you whatever you ask in my name. I'm giving you these commands so that you may love one another. Today's devotion comes from Joyce Meyer's Strength for Each Day, and it is simply entitled Love One Another. And this is what she says. The command to love each other, is repeated throughout Scripture. Loving one another is one of the best ways we can show the world that we are Christ's disciples. One way we can show love is through forgiveness, and another is through showing mercy. Is there anyone in your life right now who you need to forgive? Perhaps that person has treated you unjustly. Forgiving them may be difficult, but you can do it by God's grace. Be merciful and good to those who don't deserve it, for that is what God has done for us in Christ. Our goal should be to become like Christ in all our ways. And he is quick to forgive and plenteous in mercy. Love is much more than a feeling, it is an action. Love is seen in how we choose to treat people, including people who have wronged us. God's word teaches us that if our enemy is hungry, we should feed him. And if he is thirsty, we should give him something to drink. This means we should be willing to meet his or her needs, even when we don't feel that they deserve to have them met. Doing good in order to have good come back to us means nothing, but doing good to those who don't deserve it is doing what God does. We are all for loving one another. It sounds like such a wonderful way to live, to love one another. And then when we figure out what that looks like, it's so much harder, so much harder. And today in our devotion, she really unpacks how difficult it is when we are called on to forgive, especially those who have harmed us or hurt us or let us down. It is so hard for us to love one another. And then to treat those who have treated us poorly or those who we think don't deserve forgiveness or mercy, to offer them love and mercy and grace, it is just a hard, hard thing for us to do. Loving is a beautiful concept, but the living it is very challenging. So, first of all, we have to begin with ourselves. The first thing we need to do is to understand that we have been given an everlasting love. Not because we did the right things, not because we always said the right things or treated people the right way, not because we always took the right path, but just because God loves us. Because we are God's beloved. And when we can receive that, then we can begin the work of loving others. First, we have to be able to receive that. Today, where are the places that it's hard for you to believe that God could love you? What are the things, the voices that tell you you are not enough? You couldn't possibly be chosen by God. God has no use for you. Those are not God's voices. Those are not God's voices. Where are the places that you are finding it hardest to accept God's love into your heart? And today I invite you to hear the voice of God calling your name, calling the only name that really matters, which is that you are beloved. You are the loved one. And I need you to hear that today. You are the loved one. Now, if we are going to receive love, even when we don't deserve it, even If we are going to accept that God loves us even when we have failed or have turned to our own way, then we also have to acknowledge that others deserve that same love. That just as God loves us with our faults and our missteps, so too does God love them. And if that's the case, how can we love them as well? Where are the places that we can offer forgiveness and lay down our resentments? Where are the places that we can offer mercy so that the people we encounter, whether they're in our own families or in our workplaces or in our communities, so that they will come to know the same love that we have received. Having received this love, we are called to share it. And so this is what Jesus, this is a commandment. This isn't just a, well, if you feel like it, or if it works in your schedule. No, this is a commandment that we are first to receive and then to be that love. If we can receive this grace and this mercy and this forgiveness and this love, well then, oh, there's a bug right there. Then we are called to offer that to one another. So today, I invite you in this time of prayer to lay down the voices that tell you you're not enough. Hear the voice of the one that calls you beloved and ask God to lead you in that love. Let's pray. Merciful, grace-filled, loving God, we come this morning admitting that too often we have not listened to your voice of love. We have denied your love. We have rejected your grace. We have failed to see the value that you have placed in us. We have failed to understand that we are loved. Each one of us today with a voice of your love. When we instead choose to hear words that tear us down, turn us back to you, that we might once again hear your voice of love. Forgive us, Lord, when we have devalued ourselves and in turn, done that to those around us, those who are supposed to be our loved ones that we have treated with unkind words, with unmerciful hearts. Forgive us, Lord, when we have failed to offer grace and mercy to those who need it most in our world. Forgive us when we have too often counted the cost or offered love that was based on conditions instead of your unconditional agape love. Lead us this day on paths that will open up opportunities to love our neighbor, even the ones that are hardest to love. Show us, Lord, in the person of Jesus, how to love ourselves, and to love one another. We thank you, Lord, for this great love. Let us live in it today. We ask all of this in your name, as together we pray the prayer that you taught your disciples. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. So today, I pray that you will hear God's voice, reminding you once again that you are loved, not because you're perfect, not because you've done it right, but because you are God's beloved one. And having received that, that you might go and share it. God loves you, my friends, and so do I. Have a very blessed day, and I look forward to seeing you back here tomorrow. Bye, friends.